Next up, the best dressed man at the State Datapalooza, Fire Chief Rich Price from San Ramon, California, to talk about Pulse Point. Is Chief Price in the house? Yes, he is. There he is. Please welcome Chief Price.
Thank you, Todd. Well, Pulse Point is a revolutionary new mobile app designed to support communities that are working to improve sudden cardiac arrest survival rates through improved bystander performance and active citizenship. Not long ago, I was having lunch in a local deli when I heard a siren in a distance. And as that siren grew closer, I could see the crew coming in. I could see the lights flashing on an ambulance. And to my surprise, they pulled into the parking lot and pulled up right in front of that deli that I was eating at. I was on duty, I was in uniform, looking around to see what I might have missed. You know, this was not good news for me. And, you know, people were looking at me, probably wondering while I was casually having lunch, why there was an ambulance pulling up in front of the deli. Well, I found out very quickly that somebody right on the other side of the wall from where I was sitting had a sudden cardiac arrest and was collapsed. I likely could have made a big difference. You know, I know CPR, there was an AED available, but I just didn't know that somebody needed help so nearby. You know, had there been a fire or a chemical spill or something, as the chief, I would have been notified. But medical incidents are happening up and down my district throughout the day, all day, and it's just not something that the fire chief's tuned into. But I sure wished that there was a way that I would have known or that I could know if somebody needed help nearby. And not just myself, but I really was thinking if this was an incident that our citizens could help, if anybody that had the skills to provide help could be notified of an incident when they were nearby. And that was the beginning of a big idea. That cardiac arrest was not a rare event. 1,000 Americans die every day from sudden cardiac arrest, making it a leading cause of death in the United States. But many of these deaths would be prevented if CPR was initiated and an AED was deployed in the first few minutes after a cardiac arrest. For the last 50 years, 300 million people, over the past 50 years, 300 million people have been trained in CPR. Yet today, CPR is only performed about 25% of the time in out-of-hospital cardiac arrest cases. It's only 1 in 4 times CPR is in progress when paramedics arrive. And publicly available AEDs, defibrillators, the ones that you see in airports and schools and public assembly, places of public assembly, they're retrieved and used only 1 or 2% of the time when they're available, primarily because lay rescuers don't think about them and don't know where to find them. But without intervention, a cardiac arrest victim only has about 10 minutes to live. But CPR suspends time. It stops that 10-minute clock, and it sustains life until advanced care can arrive. Now, I oversee one of the best EMS systems in the country, and we have a response time goal in urban areas of 7 minutes. So you can see there's not much room for error. This excruciatingly short period of time, this short window of opportunity, is exactly why most people did not survive a sudden cardiac arrest. Today, more than ever, citizens helping citizens is truly the only way that the chain of survival can work. Instead of relying on fate to place a CPR-trained citizen in the exact location needed, at the exact time needed, essentially requiring a witnessed arrest, the Pulse Point app is used to dispatch nearby CPR-trained citizens simultaneously with the dispatch of local paramedics so that CPR can begin immediately and an AED defibrillator can be reliably sourced. I'm going to show you a quick PSA to give you an idea of how this works. We're using this in local movie theaters and agencies to get the app adopted.
Thank you. Thank you.
Citizens who are trained in CPR simply download the free Pulse Point app from the Apple App Store or the Google Play Market and indicate that they're willing to assist when needed. When a 911 call is received reporting somebody who's unconscious, unresponsive, that we believe likely needing CPR, the local communication center will dispatch local resources just as they do today, but software running in the center will also send an alert to nearby citizen rescuers. By using modern location technology such as GPS and today's mobile phones, the app only notifies those that are nearby, essentially within walking distance of the event. When users open the message, as you saw in the video, the app provides them an interactive map view that indicates their present location, the incident location where the patient is located, and the location of all nearby AEDs, in their context. I only have a couple of dozen paramedics on duty each day covering 155 square miles. But I have about 17,000 CPR-trained citizens across that same area. And that's quite a force multiplier. With the hands-only CPR that's being taught and promoted today, the technique is easier and more likely to be performed than ever before. So this map shows the fire stations that are protecting this community. This happens to be Alameda County in California. And this next slide shows the same county after implementing Pulse Point. So this is truly a remarkable difference in response capability. These are citizens with the app installed, standing by to assist when needed. So this is the force multiplier that I reference. When CPR begins and an AED is deployed, in the first few minutes after a cardiac arrest, survival rates can approach 80%. But if patients arrive at the local hospital already dead, our best doctors and our latest protocols have no opportunity to make any difference at all. So therein lies the promise of the Pulse Point app, to deliver patients to the emergency room that are still alive so they can benefit from all the interventions and innovations that are available to cardiac patients today. Nationwide, only 8% of sudden cardiac arrest victims survive, leading 92% unable to benefit from today's in-hospital advances. The Pulse Point app uses freely available local government public safety dispatch data. The mobile app and the supporting infrastructure are made available at no cost to any public safety agency through the nonprofit Pulse Point Foundation. A public API connects this local government data to Pulse Point. This is a modern web services implementation hosted on the Amazon EC2 cloud. We also have a separate API for AED aggregators to provide AED device location information to the app in real time. The app also gives community leaders the ability to message these mobile users geographically, a capability that we added after discussions we had here at the White House at the recent safety data jam. The Pulse Point app has been the recipient of several prestigious awards, including an American Heart Association Heart of Gold Award, a Webby nomination in the Best Use of GPS or Location Technology category, a Computer World's Honor Laureate Medal for Innovation, a VITA Wireless Samaritan Award. I know Ben from the Wireless Foundation is here. Thank you, Ben. And the 2011 International Association of Fire Chiefs Fire Service Award for Excellence. Mary Beth from the IFC, thank you for being here representing the fire service, Mary Beth. So that's our big contribution to the Datapalooza and to America. The ability to crowdsource Good Samaritans in communities across the U.S. to reduce collapse to CPR and collapse to defibrillation times by simultaneously dispatching nearby CPR-trained citizens to those in need of CPR. So if you'd like to learn more about the collective action the Pulse Point app enables, or to learn more about the mission of the Pulse Point Foundation, you can visit us at pulsepoint.org. You can follow at Pulse Point I have a board member here from the Pulse Point Foundation, Don Ledoux. He'll be joining me at the expo to answer questions that you're certain to have about this new technology. So Todd, Brian, thank you very much for the opportunity to speak here at the White House. It was an honor.